Hello, wonderful people. This is Stephanie Nadolny for WonderBot Animals, and here is...
A couple takes in emaciated homeless husky and are astonished at his transformation.
Before we begin, make sure to click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification button for more amazing videos.
Around 70 million stray animals roam the United States, and of that number, only 6 to 8 million of them reportedly end up in shelters. Not every stray animal is so lucky to end up in a shelter, and when that is the case, their fates are unknowable and almost hopeless. Such was the case for a young husky found roaming the streets of Houston. After a couple decided to take him in, they started to see the dog he really was. One woman and her husband saw a friend's Facebook post about a stray husky in their neighborhood. The friend took the dog in, but asked if anyone would be able to give him a home. The husband, who grew up with huskies, immediately obliged. The couple went to the friend's house to meet the homeless husky. But when they got there, they noticed something that was quite odd. "When we arrived, he immediately came up to me, but avoided my husband," wrote the woman, who was known as strategically placed bananas on Imgur. Soon they realized that it wasn't just her husband that the husky was afraid of, but it was men in general. "He was very wary around men and wouldn't let them touch or pet him," the woman added. But that wasn't the only thing they noticed about this dog. What was most apparent about the husky when the couple first met him was the terrible condition he was in. As you can see, he's in pretty bad shape in this photo. Notice the patchy fur and the visible ribs. "He also had a large scar going across his ribs that might be hard to see at this angle," she wrote. The husky's condition paired with his fear of men led the couple to wonder what he had been through. Despite the dog's condition, the couple ultimately decided to give him a home. Because he had no collar and no chip, there was no way of identifying the husky or his origins. The couple decided to name him Wolfgar. They took him to the vet the same day that they picked him up from their friend's house. The vets found that Wolfgar was severely underweight, which suggests he was malnourished for quite a while. Though he somehow didn't have any heartworms or fleas, Wolfgar's diagnosis was actually pretty serious. The vet did a scraping and found out he had demodectic mange. Huskies have two coats. So for his skin to be so red, dry, and patchy, he had to be infected for quite some time, the Imgur user wrote. Wolfgar was given a shot for his immune system and put on antibiotics as the first step on his road to recovery. The couple took Wolfgar home and got him a kennel to sleep in. Wolfgar went inside right away, which suggested to his new humans that he was previously crate trained. This led to more questions about Wolfgar's origins. "We checked lost and found boards online, dating back months for the city of Houston, and didn't find any fitting his age or description. As far as we could tell, nobody was missing him," she wrote. The couple came to the conclusion that Wolfgar escaped from a horrid situation, but only after they went through several possible theories. Perhaps he escaped on his own from an abusive, negligent owner, which might explain the scar. He was purposely abandoned. He belonged to an unlicensed breeder and escaped. Huskies aren't typically a breed you find wandering the streets, so we're strongly leaning towards the escaped theory, especially considering his wariness around men, the wife wrote. The first few nights in his new home, Wolfgar would spend them crying in his kennel. It took a while before he truly got used to his new home. At first, the couple had Wolfgar sleep separately from them, which is probably why he cried so much at first. "Unfortunately, due to his mange, we didn't want him sleeping in our room with us because the bedrooms were carpeted," the wife wrote. After Wolfgar started feeling more comfortable, the couple noticed that his primary activity was napping. Though nobody knows what Wolfgar had been through before he was found, he was likely incredibly tired from the entire ordeal, which is why he slept so much once he was in a safe place. "Now he primarily naps in his kennel or on a fluffy blanket in the living room," the wife wrote next to a photo of Wolfgar sleeping. As the weeks passed, the couple watched as Wolfgar started breaking out of his shell and displaying regular dog behavior. Wolfgar must have caught on that his new humans truly cared about him, and it seemed he began to appreciate everything that came with that love. The wife shared this photo of Wolfgar and added, "He's staring at a treat in my hand. Sometimes it's the only way to get him to look at the camera." Soon, the couple began taking Wolfgar out to the local dog park. On his first visit, he apparently had a great time and surprised his new owners by showing how friendly he could be with other dogs. "I was worried about how he'd act around other dogs, but in typical Husky fashion, he was friendly and playful right off the bat, the wife wrote. It was clear that Wolfgar had started to let his guard down. Wolfgar had proven how friendly he could be, but doesn't really react to dogs who don't like him. The Husky Shepherd mix on the right wasn't too pleased to see Wolfgar. He plays well with most other dogs, provided they're also friendly. Since then, we've encountered dogs that are aggressive or bark at him. He's very quiet as far as huskies go, so he never barks back. He mostly stares in confusion, writes the wife. Despite the trauma he suffered in the past, the couple was relieved to see that Wolfgar had left it all behind and started opening up in his new life. In fact, he seemed eager to interact with other dogs, especially when they're fellow huskies. Wolfgar tries to engage my in-law's senior husky. Notice how sparse his tail is in this picture, writes the wife. But soon, the couple noticed that things were starting to change. There were some habits that Wolfgar held on to for a while, such as his penchant for sleeping. Still, the couple noticed rapid changes that happened once Wolfgar was settled into his new life. We noticed that as he grew in new hair, it began to change color. When we first got him, his coat was a distinct red color. Here, it's more of a gray color, and even darker in the sunlight, writes the wife. As Wolfgar started to change, the couple noticed a lot more things about Wolfgar's personality. It was almost immediately apparent that Wolfgar absolutely loved car rides. When they first got Wolfgar, the couple noted how often he'd whine and whimper into the night. He must have felt incredibly lonely and afraid at first, especially since he was in an unfamiliar place. But soon it became apparent that this couple was there to nurture Wolfgar, instead of inflict whatever unthinkable pain he'd previously suffered. It wasn't long before he felt safe enough to sleep peacefully, like he is in this photo. Wolfgar began looking like a brand new dog within 3 months of living with his new humans. They got him in early November, but by mid-January, his healing had begun to show physically. You can see his neck fur starting to thicken. He loves going into the backyard. He likes to sit and observe the other people in the neighborhood. When people walk too close, he'd bark. We liked this protective aspect, the wife writes. As Wolfgar began displaying new changes, the couple noticed a lot of little oddities in his behavior as well. Perhaps Wolfgar's preference for perching, as seen in this photo, shows that he does like to have a moment to chill out. But that wasn't the only new thing the couple noticed about Wolfgar. They were still in for more surprises. By the time February rolled around, the most surprising change in Wolfgar came to light. As his fur started growing back, the couple realized they'd made a misconception about their new dog. A lot of Wolfgar's identity was literally stripped away from him, but now it was growing back. You can really see how his coat darkened in this picture. I'm hoping this is just a winter coat, because I loved his red coloring before, the wife writes. Wolfgar had become a completely different dog within a few short months of living in his new forever home, but his story didn't end there. These days, Wolfgar is out there living his best life. After treating every day like a new adventure, Wolfgar comes home and splays out on the cool tiles to take a nap, as you see here. As the couple continue to love him, Wolfgar continued to grow in amazing ways. As you can see, Wolfgar is filled with pure joy and elation as he settles in the car for the day's next adventure. If you recall, he was once a timid dog that was afraid in the presence of certain humans. But this does not look like that dog at all. This is the new Wolfgar, who lives with so much joy de vivre that every car ride feels like the beginning of a roller coaster. It's clear that Wolfgar loves going for a drive, and it probably helps that his humans roll down the windows for him. With the windows down, Wolfgar gets to enjoy the full experience and will even stick his head out on occasion. We've all seen dogs on the road that do this as they're cruising down the highway. With the wind blowing across their furry faces, they look like they're in a state of pure bliss. Wolfgar's new human mom soon caught on that he knew whenever they were headed to the dog park. He's actually memorized the route. As we get closer, he starts whining and hopping around in the back seat out of excitement, wrote the wife of the couple. In this picture, he's looking at his human as if to say, "Enough pictures already! Let's get out there and play!" On this day, he came out of the car looking brand new. Wolfgar started looking like his real canine self in no time. If you recall, just as he started opening up, his tail was still sparse. But soon, it had grown into the beautifully bushy tail that huskies are generally known for. Remember how wispy his tail was before? The wife wrote with this picture. This picture was taken last weekend. This shows how much fur he's grown back from December to now. Sometimes Wolfgar sticks his curious nose in places he shouldn't be. What might this delicious smell be up here? He must be wondering. But his human mom assures that Wolfgar doesn't get people food. Still, you can't blame a dog for trying. You also might notice how incredibly healthy Wolfgar started looking over time. In the earlier photos, he looked incredibly emaciated. But look at him here. He obviously has a whole new appetite. That husky stare, though, the wife of the couple captioned this photo. There's something mystical about a husky's eyes, especially those that have piercing blue ones. Blue eyes are a common trait in Siberian huskies, which might suggest Wolfgar's heritage. Studies have found that their eyes aren't actually blue. Their eyes appear blue because of the way light enters and exits them due to a lack of pigment. Blue-eyed dogs have a gene mutation that causes this. He's now a happy, healthy, spoiled dog, and we love him in all the fur he leaves on our clothes, the wife of the couple concludes. In just a few short months, they took in and rehabilitated Wolfgar until he was a completely new dog. The wife urged readers of her post to adopt or volunteer at local shelters if they are able to. There are plenty of animals there who can only dream of a life like Wolfgar's.